So many of you are not submitted the assignments. If you are not submitted, please submit the assignments as early as possible. It will be evaluated for 5 marks. Is that clear? Okay, we'll start with the class now. So in the previous class, we just discussed about the lexical conventions. So how to write the program, or what is the perfect syntax of writing a program. So always I assist that coding is not as easy as we think. It's not just by writing the programs. It is learning how to write them. First, understand what you are trying to do. Then try to write the programs in the same syntax. The syntax error can be corrected, but your logic levels or the logic analysis skills depends on individuals. So what I mean to say is the basic understanding of logic design subject is very essential if you want to excel in this subject. The subject is just very easy. In my point of view, it is very easy. So straight away we'll start it. I'll just share the screen now. Okay. So we have come across how to write the numbers, size numbers, unsized numbers in the previous class, along with the X or Z real values or the X or Z values. X stands for your unknown. Along with 0, 1, you can give a signal, or you can give a signal can take 4 values. A bit can take 4 values. What is that? 0, 1, X or Z. 0, 1, X or Z. So this is about your Verilog values. So that is 1, 0, 1 along with X and Z. Negative numbers, you can also write the negative numbers as we have seen in the previous class. How to write the negative numbers? What about the underscore character? An underscore character is allowed where anywhere in the number except the first character. So you can use the underscore character. Underscore characters are allowed only to improve readability of numbers and are ignored by Verilog. Suppose there is a 16-bit number. Say, for example, so this is the number. I'll just type the number 0001 0010 0011. Suppose this is a number. Looking at this number, we cannot easily make out what is the value. Otherwise, if I just put an underscore here, we can clearly distinguish the numbers. So in order to make the numbers readable, we'll be using underscore. This is an example. Okay. This is the example of writing the underscore or using the underscore to read the numbers. So this underscore is ignored by Verilog, and the whole number is taken as 00040s, 301, 0010, 0011, like this. What is the point? Hello, are you guys following? ಹಲೋ ಹೇಳಿ. ನಮಸ್ತೆ. ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಹೇಳಿ. Are you guys following? No. Shweta Karant, okay, fine. Pragna Praveen. Try to understand subject. Okay, first we have discussed only we are trying to write the syntax of the Verilog program. We are trying to learn the syntax of the Verilog programs. Okay, this is the example of using the underscore character. Question mark, what is the use of question mark? Yes, the question mark is the Verilog HTL alternative for Z in the context of numbers. So if the value is high impedance, you can use question mark. For example, this is the use of underscore character. Then 4 tick binary 10, we don't know the value ZZ. Then you can use put the question mark. So question mark is an alternative for Z. Question mark is an alternative for z. Remember that if you know don't know the numbers, you can either write zz or question mark like this. So here in this case, it is four tick binary number. The first two numbers are known, 10. The later numbers are zz. You can just put the question mark here. You can just put the question mark and write the program. Okay. Okay. Now string. How a string is written? String means the sentences. The string is a sequence of characters that are enclosed by double quotes. So if you have a something to be displayed on a screen, you should use your strings. Strings are a sequence of characters. It is a sequence of characters. So it, you can use a white space here. So whatever you write in the double quotes, it will be treated as a string in Verilog. The restriction of a string is that it must be contained on a single line. That is without a carriage return. So you should not enter. You should not. It should be in a single line. String should be contained in a single line. Strings are treated as a sequence of 1-byte ASCII values. So if I press A, the ASCII value of A will be stored in Verilog. Or you can just A is not recognized by Verilog. The ASCII value of A will be treated as A will be taken by Verilog. Examples, hello Verilog world is a string. Hello Verilog world is a string. So you can see here in double quotes we have put the sentence. Hello Verilog world is a sentence. So this is a string. So now if I write it in this fashion, A double quotes A by B or A bar B. So this is a string. This is a valid string. Okay. So now the next is identifiers and keywords. So keywords, as I mentioned, so anything that turns blue is a keyword. Keywords are special identifier reserved to define the language constructs. Keywords are in lowercase. They are in lowercase. Identifiers are names given to objects so that they can be redefined in the design or they can be referenced in the design easily. Identifiers are made up of alphanumeric characters, example underscore or dollar sign. So now there is a clear distinction between keywords and identifiers. Keywords are those which we can say it is a language construct. So this is a, if there is a language construct, if the language by default it is used, that will appear blue in color. That will appear blue in color. So that is a keyword. Keywords are in lowercase always. Keywords are in lowercase. Sorry. Identifiers are case sensitive. Identifier starts with an alphabetic character or an underscore. They cannot start with a digit or a dollar sign. A dollar sign are the first characters reserved for system tasks. So system task, here the system task is dollar, whatever dollar is there that is used to mention system task. For example, dollar monitor. Dollar monitor will monitor the whatever value we will be giving. Dollar display. Dollar display will do, is a system task. So wherever you find a dollar, you should understand that it is a system task. It's a system task. Examples are given here. REG value. REG value. REG is a keyword. REG is a keyword. Value is an identifier. Input clock. Input is a keyword. Clock is an identifier. CLK is an identifier, whereas input will be blue in color. Input will be blue in color. So this is how we can definitely identify the difference between keywords and identifiers. Escape identifier. So escape identifiers begin with the backslash. Example A plus B minus C. So all characters between backslash and white space are processed literally. Any printable ASCII character can be included in the escape identifiers. So escape identifiers, don't confuse here. Just try to know there are two types of things. One is the keyword, the other is your identifier. Escape identifiers will never use this in your programs. If you use that also, will come. I'll explain you in the later classes. Okay. Don't confuse there at this point. You just remember that we have identifiers and keywords. Keywords are special identifiers reserved to define the language constructs. Keywords are in lowercase. Identifiers are names given to the objects that can be referenced in the design. Examples are here. Value is a identifier. Register, REG is a keyword. Input is a keyword. Clock is the identifier. Now let us try to write a simple program. In Verilog, I'll just update a program, try to analyze that program in analyze the program. Let us try to write a program now. Wait 1 second, I'll just put the program. So in the previous class I have given you a program. I'll have to take a paper and pen and write this program also. Have a pen and paper in my class to note down things. Yeah, just try to write the black box view of this code. Black box view. So what are the inputs here? D underscore in, it is 2-bit. Enable is one type of enable is also input. Output, you have one output, D underscore output. So what program is this? It's a decoder program. The size of the decoder is 2 to 4 decoder. Decoder performs the ulta operation of encoder. What is that? Reverse operation of encoder. So if you just want, I'll just write here the black box. Okay, wait 1 second. Control C. Hold on a minute. Okay. Are you guys able to see the black box? Hello. Yeah. Are you guys able to see the black box? Reply me. Black box and truth table is written, right? Hello. Okay. So just note down the black box first, then note down the truth table. All of you note down the black box. Completed. Take a pen, paper, note down this block diagram and truth table of 2 to 4 decoder. Completed the truth table. So observe the truth table here. If enable is one, it is low enable. Low enable means active low enable. A zero on this enable will switch on the device. A one on the device will turn off the device. So irrespective of inputs, the first case enable is one here because enable bar we have a low enable here. Zero on that will turn on the circuit. So the first case is one, enable is one here. Try to analyze line by line. Try to analyze one by one. Enable is one. Now look here, the values input are don't care z z z z 2 to 4 decode. You have two inputs. From that two inputs, four outputs will be driven or four outputs will be obtained. So next I'll be making sure that I am putting a zero here. So put a zero here. Input is 0 0. So what you will get at the output is the elaborated version of the decoded output. 0 0 0 1. So what I'm trying to say is, so if my inputs are 0 0, the output would be 0 0 0 1. If the enable is zero, the system is on, the device circuit is on now. The inputs are 0 1 0 1. What about the output? 0 0 1 0. So this D underscore output one has become one. Look at similarly for 1 0, it is 0 1 0 0. For 1 1, it is 1 0 0 0. So if you understand the truth table, we can easily understand the program. So look at the program now. All of you have completed the copying of the truth table and the black box. You can unmute and you can speak. Completed the copying of the truth table and program. Sorry, truth table and the black box view. Hello. You should reply me, guys. Hello. Anybody reply me? Have you completed the copying of this black box and truth table? Yeah, fine. It is rest can also chat. Only a few people are chatting with me. You can many can chat. Okay, only a few repeated names. Okay, fine. And once you complete this black box, now try to analyze the program. Now module decoder, module name and the input list, input and output list. D underscore in is input, enable is input. Output is D underscore output, close the parenthesis, semicolon. Input is of 2 bits. How to define 2 bits? Open the square braces. 2 bits, 1:0, D underscore in. So we have defined a input of size 2 bits. Enable is 1 bit, directly write, nothing is required here. Output enable is 1 bit. Output 3:0, D underscore output, D underscore output. Register. I want to save the output in one register. That's why I will be using this sentence reg, where it is also 4 bits same. So whatever is coming at the output, save it. Save register 3:0 d underscore output. Now we always use this line in the program. Always add yavag yavag andre. Always add. When your mom gives you tindi, will be very active, right? Similarly, always at is the sentence to which your program will react. So program will React always at these two. Din matte enable idre always at the input as well as enable. If they are present, begin. If enable is equal to 1, so enable na 1 madidre nam device off aagbeku. Nam device off aagbeku yakandre it is a active low. It is active low. It is active. That is why if enable is equal to 1 at the beginning condition, begin if enable is equal to 1, enable 1 agidana andre namdu circuit off agide avaga enu barbeku output d underscore output is equal to 4 tick binary z z z z. So it is very familiar with your truth table. The program is very familiar with truth table. Afterwards you can compare it. Else illa, else andre if enable is not 0 now, else andre artha eno, enable 1 ittu andre so this is the value that is coming at the output. Illa enable 0 ide iga, else avaga en martira case baritira case d underscore in. D underscore in in case first case eno d underscore in is the case 2 tick 00 ittu andre 2 tick binary 00 ittu yavdu d in avaga en aagbeku d underscore output is 4 tick binary 000 on the first line of your truth table, sorry, the second line of your truth table. This is the third line of your truth table. If d underscore n is 2 tick binary 01, d underscore output is this third line of your truth table, the fourth line of your truth table, the fifth line of your truth table. Idyadu illa sir, I'll give it as 0x sir avage nanu sir, and I'll give it as 0x sir, 2 tick binary 0x. Then you have to write a default case. Default idalldene yadaro bere bantu andre, if that is the case, then you have to write d underscore output is equal to 4 tick binary I don't care. So we have opened the case here, end the case. We open a if here, end it. If will open madidivi, end maartta idivi, begin madidivi, end maartta idivi, begin aitu end aitu, case aitu end case aitu, module ge end module. Very simple program. First thing is you should know the block diagram. The block diagram will tell about the inputs and outputs of the program. Next thing is you should write the truth table properly. The same truth table we have written in this part. That's it. Very simple programming. Very simple. Same truth table. If you look at the truth table and the sentence, it is nothing but your truth table only. Right? Got the point, guys? Reply me. Artha aita. Once again, if I want to explain, I'll explain. If you guys want once again to explain, I'll explain once again. Understand the programming, then Verilog would be very easy. What we have done? Nothing. We have written the truth table. We have written the block diagram first. Then we have written the truth table. The same truth table written in the form of Verilog code. Very straightforward programming approach. This is one style of programming. The remaining styles are there that in the earlier classes, in the later classes, I'll explain. Okay. Is that clear, guys? Okay, then if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, I'll end here. So two programs were discussed. That is the three programs. One is the code for all gates. Then the next is encoder, 8 to 3 encoder. Then the next thing is 2 to 4 decoder. So now backtrack your 8 to 3 encoder. Try to analyze the program by yourself. Many people have not submitted the assignment. You can submit it. It will be valid for 5 marks. Any doubts, guys? Guys, any doubt? ಅಂತೋ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮಾತಾಡೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮಾತಾಡ್ರೋ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ರೋ ನೋ 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 ಓನ್ಲಿ 2 ಗೈಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 40 ನೋ remaining I have doubts are, okay, all of you watch cricket, right? All of you watch cricket. In that, the batsman, if there is a bouncer, he'll leave the ball. If there is a bouncer, he leaves the ball. Otherwise, he'll hit a hit that ball nicely. One thing is, either will be I am the bowler and you are the batsman. I assume that everything is going inside your head or it is above your head. What shall I assume? Inside your head or above your head? Okay, don't panic. It's very easy. Only thing, you should show little interest. Then coding is very easy. Verilog coding is very easy. With this, I'll stop here. You can put your USN and name. ಇದಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಪಟ 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 ಬರ್ತಾವೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ಹಾಂ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ಬರ್ತು ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಬೇರೆದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ, ಈಗ ಪಟ 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 ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನೇಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್, ದೋಸ್ ಪುಟ್ ದಿ ಯುಎಸ್ಎನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೇಮ್, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಲೀವ್ ದಿ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ಟುಮಾರೋ ವಿ ಗೈಸ್ ಶಾಲ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಅಟ್ 11:30. ಓಕೆ, ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್, ಬಾಯ್, ಗುಡ್ ಬೈ. ಓಕೆ ಮನೀಶ್, ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಗಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ನಾವು ಒಂಥರದ ಹಂಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ಕಪ್ಪು ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ, ಬರಲ್ಲ ಕಪ್ಪು. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ವಿಲ್ ಹೋಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್. Okay guys, thank you.